The Equal Opportunities Commission has engaged religious leaders on how the government can ensure equitable, inclusive, gender-sensitive, and diverse development. In the meeting, different religious leaders raised a number of concerns that are hindering equality in the country. Dr. Ali Waiswa, the second deputy mufti of the Uganda Muslim Supreme Council, notes that until corruption is dealt with through auditing, this country cannot achieve the much desired equality.
There is no disease we are suffering most other than corruption. And corruption is a disease, a very big disease, because whatever that we do, if that animal is within our house, I think little will be achieved.
Dr. Waiswa further notes that whereas the religious institutions are doing a great job in extending services to the vulnerable communities, they are only doing so with the help of donors who sometimes have a lot of conditions and sometimes contravene the religious values.
To promote values that serve our nation appropriately and without any force or any foreign hand into it. Otherwise, we shall be subject to somehow lenience in some directions because of the need.
The religious leaders also demand for the financial empowerment of religious institutions to enable them to do their role of motivating the populace to work harder for their development.
Unity in diversity and harmonious living. We get those audits, those benchmarks, and say this and this qualifies. If we do this well, they will give us equitable, diverse, and inclusive development. Health for all.
The chairperson of the Equal Opportunities Commission explains that the meeting was intended to audit the responsiveness of the public and private sector on the equalization of opportunities in the country.
We are auditing the responsiveness of the works of the private and public institutions on equalization of opportunities, affirmative action, gender and equity responsiveness to ensure inclusive development.
The Equal Opportunities Commission of Uganda is mandated to eliminate discrimination and inequalities against an individual or group of persons on the grounds of sex, race, color, ethnic origin, tribe, birth, creed or religion, health status, social or economic standing, political opinion or disability, and take affirmative action in favor of groups marginalized on the basis of gender, age, disability or any other reason created by history, tradition or custom for the purpose of redressing imbalances which exist against them and to provide for other related matters. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.